So, I finally released the Sig and Tessa short. It's doing about as well as I expected considering it isn't a video game parody, but it also made me hit a realization. Sure, there's tons of videos talking about the difficulty of being an animator, more so one on YouTube. I'm only gonna vaguely touch on that. I more so wanna touch on being a solo Flash artist. Flash cartoons have evolved and changed a lot over the years, but I feel as though they've hit a snag. It seems as though recently, unless you've gotten a following, it's very difficult to become anything more than a parody artist if you're using Flash as your medium and you're working alone. Even with some of the more well-trafficked animators, most of their original works gets far less views than any parody they create. I mean, it's basic. Obviously, parodies have a wider audience because people will click the video and watch them with the mindset, I know this. Tons of people play video games, so tons of people watch video game parodies. There's nothing wrong with making video game parodies or any kind of parodies. What I instead want to get into, or rather do, is try and help those who are trying to do some original work. If you've got a series in mind, do it. Or maybe you've already released some cartoons towards it. I want to help. As I worked on Sig and Tessa, I released plenty of things online showing my work and progress on it. A few of the animators I looked up to expressed interest in it, liking and commenting on some of my progress posts. I had discussions with a few artists and animators about working on original projects and the hardships of it. It felt good to talk with these people I look up to and think that they had a similar mindset. I thought maybe when I released my cartoon, they'd know how much work I put into it and how much it meant to me. I thought they'd help share it and maybe boost it a bit. I've seen them do it before on their blog, sharing and liking videos for people they didn't even know, animators they thought earned it. But when I released my cartoon, despite them expressing interest in my work process, I didn't make the cut, I guess. Whether it was to them my animation wasn't good enough in quality, or maybe they just didn't like it. Whatever the reason, it remained off their pages. And by no way am I saying it's their job to share my work, they have no obligation to, even if they did express interest. This isn't some witch hunt and I'm not bad-mouthing them at all, more so leading up to my point. I think Flash artists get it in their head that there are levels in terms of internet fame. Obviously, everyone aspires to be like the most well-known animators like Psychic Pebbles, Oni, Harry Partridge, Rice Pirate. Most Flash artists view them as gods, and everyone wants to be on that level of fame. There's other levels too, and I don't think anyone means it with ill intent, but I think subconsciously, you put yourself on a level based on your subscribers or views. I know I myself am terrified to talk to people with more subscribers than me, but at the same time, I tend to ignore those with less. I don't want to do this anymore. I want to help those that want to create original work. I want to share your work. I want to offer what little advice I can. I want to help promote it. So I guess what this whole rant is about is, I want to try and make a movement to make more original work. By no means am I saying parodies are bad, don't make them. If you like making parodies, that's great, go for it. But if you're like me and you want to start your own series, that's where I want to help. When I streamed the work sessions for Sig and Tessa, there were other animators in the chat room, lesser known and some well known. But all we did was chat. We talked about animation, our cartoons, some of them even shared their work, and others responded in turn. I want that to happen more often. I'm creating a YouTube playlist called The Wonderful A113, kind of a animation and Wonderful 101 parody. The name's not important. But I want to fill this playlist with original Flash animations, artists struggling to get their series off the ground, or even just artists that want a little extra publicity for their series. To be honest, I'm not sure how many original series are even out and about in the Flash community, or if this video will reach them, but I want to try. Even though I'm not the best animator, I'll do my best to offer advice, too. Maybe this is a moot point, but I really just want to try. Just like how even though my Sig and Tessa cartoon did worse than my video game parodies, I'm not just gonna quit on it. I'm gonna keep working on it, and I'm gonna make it better. And I want to help you do the same for your series. Or shorts, just original work. I just want there to be more originality in the Flash community. And I say that meaning stuff that you created, not in the mindset that parodies are all the same work. Well, I probably offended enough people on accident, so I guess I'll wrap this up. If you have some original work that you want to share, or you want some advice, or even just to chat, feel free to send me a message or a comment or something. The best place to probably contact me would probably be my Tumblr. You can either send the fan mail or just ask a question. I don't really know the difference, but whatever. Oh, and since it's a pretty basic one, If you're going to ask what software I use, it's Adobe Flash Professional CS 5.5. Although, sometimes when I do line art, I tend to use Macromedia Flash 8 just for the line art. That's about it!
So...
Team! Unite up!
that was cool.